Hi, in this video we'll be taking a look at powers. Now this is aimed at Key Stage 3 maths and also GCSE higher tier and also foundation. So the first section is looking at foundation, the second section at surds is looking at higher tier only. We're going to start with question number 1. Write each product as a single power. 7 squared times 7 to the 4. So I add the powers, and it's the same base, I just add the powers. So I'm going to have 7 to the power of 6. Sorry, power of 7, sorry. 4 plus 3 is 7. Sorry. Part C, 10 cubed times 10. Well, again, it's going to be 10 to the power of 4. Here, when I've got a bracket raised to a power, I multiply the powers. 5 to the 4 times 3 is 5 to the 12. Okay? For part B, 6 to 9 divided by 6 to the 4, we're going to subtract the powers, okay, providing the bases are the same. 6 to the 4 is 5, so it's 6 to the power of 5. Okay? 11 to the 5 divided by 11. Well, again, imagine I've got 11 to the power of 1 there. So I subtract the powers. 5 take away 1 is 4. Okay? For part F, 10 to the 6 always to the power of 5. And I'm going to multiply the powers. 6 times 5 is 30. Okay? This one, I've got 3 to the 5 times 3 to the 4 divided by 3 to the 1. So 5 plus 4 is 9, take away that 1 is 8. So it's 3 to the power of 8. Okay, I've got 6 plus 1 is 7, take away 5 is 5 to the power of 2. Okay, this is question number 2. Simplify 7 to the 5 times 7 to the cube. Well, I'm going to add the powers on the top of the numerator. I get 7 to the 8 divided by 7 to the 6. 8 take away 6 is 2. Okay, so the answer is 7 squared. Okay? This is question number 3. Write 3 to the minus 4 as a fraction. Well, that minus flips it, so it's the reciprocal. So it's 1 over 3 to the power of 4. Now, 3 to the power of 4 means 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, which is 1 over 81. Okay? So when you have a negative power, it's what we call the reciprocal, it's the inverse of it. Okay, imagine I've got 3 over 1, and I flip that, I get 1 third. Okay, question number 4, a 7 squared, well, is 1 over 49. Okay, 1 squared is 1, and 7 squared is 49. That's going to be 1 over 4 cubed, which is 1 over 64. Okay, minus 3 to the power of 3 is minus 27. Okay, because it's minus 3 times minus 3 times minus 3. Okay, again, minus 8 all squared is minus 8 times minus 8, which is positive 64. Okay, 3 tenths all squared is going to be 9 over 100. Because 3 squared is 9. 10 squared is 100. 15 to the power of 1 is a 15. Anything to the power of 1 just stays as itself. 20 to the power of 0. Anything to the power of 0 in maths is just 1. This one says 36 to the power of a half. Now, power of a half means the square root. So, square root of 36, which is 6. Okay? And then this last one says 1,000 to the power of third. Well, it's the cube root. Okay, so it's the third root of 1,000. We just call it cube root. So cube root of 1,000 is 10. Okay. This is question number 1 on the third section. Circle the surds. So, it's the square root that doesn't give me a whole number answer. Now, root 10 is a surd. Root 2 is a surd. Root 16 gives me the answer of 4, so that's not a surd. Root 25 gives me 5. Root 7 is a surd. This one I don't believe so, because I can write it as an improper fraction. 20 and a quarter. it becomes 81 over 4, which becomes 9 over 2. So this one I can write it as 81 quarters. I think it's making sense so far. It's question number 2. Simplify root 9 times root 3. Well, root 9 is 3 times root 3 is root 3. Okay, I'm going to have root 5 times the square root of 36. Now, this 36 we should know is a square number. So the answer is going to be 6. 6 times root 5 is just a 6 root of 5. This is root 7 over root 64. Now, root 7 stays the same, so the answer becomes root 7 over 8. Okay? And that can't be simplified, yeah. Root 63 is root 9 times root 7. Okay? Root 9 is 3. 3 times root 7 is 3 root 7, yeah. Root 15 is root 25 times root 2. Root 25 is 5. So the answer just simplifies to 5 times root 2, which is 5 root 2. Okay, so 5 goes in the middle here, times root 2. Okay, this is going to be root 36 times root 3. Okay. Which is going to equal to 6 root 3. Okay. This is question number 4. Root 20 in the form k root 5. Okay, so root 20 is root 4 times root 5. Root 4 is 2. 2 root 5. Okay? Now, this is a typical exam-style question for the higher tier. So make sure that you are happy with these sorts of questions. Question number 5. Again, it's a non-calculator. Write root 98 in the form k root 2. So root 98 is root 49 times root 2. Root 49, we should know, simplifies to 7, because 49 is a square number. 49, so square root of 49 times square root of 2 is equal to 7 root 2. Okay? And that takes us to the end of today's worksheet. Okay, so I hope you found it useful and I hope you found it informative. If you did, please press like, please subscribe to the channel if you're new, and lastly, please turn on post notification by clicking that bell icon so you don't miss out on further videos and further uploads. But that's it for me today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Take care, stay safe, and I'll see you for the next one.